So here we see the visualization of rain pressure in two bars. So the left bar is for the left rain and the right bar is for the right rain. Continuously, we calculate the maximum values in the past second. We also calculate the minimum values in the past second. Okay, so now we are training with rain sensors and we get information on the pressure that is actually applied to the horse's mouth. But it is actually a result of multiple factors. Now that we have data, we can also set ourselves some new challenges. For example, a big issue for many riders is in the extended trot, where you see that the horse has difficulty to keep his balance throughout the extended trot, and he will actually tip over to the front and become heavier on the rein, where the goal should be in the extended trot that he will keep his hind leg engaged and stay light and balanced without actually flipping forward and resulting into a higher rein pressure. So this is something we can now train for. Make an extended trot but without increasing the pressure throughout the diagonal, or in this case the long side. Two preparations. First, he needs to be collected, so a little bit more engaged with the hind leg. And then if you come out of that corner, first you straighten the horse before you go into extended trot. Good. So now we have about 3 to 4 kilograms. Keep it light, balance him on his hind leg. Yeah, nice, that's it. Straight into the extension. 5 kilograms, nice, keep it light, and stop. There he went, good, good. Enough, goed. So you see still that he, in this area, he gets heavier, 7 to 8 kilograms. So make sure you stop before he gets heavy. So do only half the long side. Stop at the beat, because I see in this area, he is losing his balance and going back to 7 to 8 kilograms. Nicely done. But nicely straight this time. Very well straightened out before you go into the extension. Good. We do it again. Balance. Hind leg engaged. Keep him quick because he's such a big boy, but keep him quick. Yeah, but not heavy. Nice. Well done. Well done. Extension. Yeah. And again, you were busy with straightening him out. During that extension. So he was walking away over your right shoulder, right?
Yeah.
Okay, prepare that before you go into extension. We're at home, it doesn't matter. But make him straight first and then extend. Okay. Just chop it off, eh? You have all the time. First straight. Connection, hind leg engaged. There. Don't bend him too much in the neck. Give him a little bit more space in the front to, yeah, extend the nose. Yeah. That's it. That. So you put your, yes, your hands towards your ears. That's it. This is good. This is very nice, light, straight, 3 to 4 kilograms. Perfect. There we go. Straight. So the the shoulder in. That's nice. Enough, enough. Don't overdo it. Ah, that's it. And now we stayed at 5 kilograms. And then go back to the normal trot. Okay. A little walk. Take a breather. A breather. Oh, one more time. That's okay. Good. You feel what I mean?
Yeah.
Big horses like this get a little bit heavier in the canter. So we see now the pressure going up to about 6 kilograms of maximum contact, of maximum pressure. And again, that has to do with the biomechanics of the horse. Every step he takes, his head nods a little bit down. And the more a horse is able to carry himself, the lighter this pressure will get. So where you would have 3 to 4 kilograms in the trot, now you go up, not even that much higher, oh, Anke. 4 kilograms still in the canter as well. Does he feel heavy for you now?
No.
No, he's very nice. Yeah, very good. Now if you give the aids, we were working in the trot a little bit on the right side, getting the shoulder in. In the trot, you would do that with only 4 kilos, so only 1 kilo extra. Now I see that you are giving bigger aids in the canter. Is that intentionally?
No.
Oh. Because maybe it's also a big movement, and you need to be able to coordinate your hands and your ace the same way, because now you are doing 8 kilograms on your right rein to get that shoulder in.
Okay.
Where in trot you could do it with way less. So try to keep your communication as small as possible. If he doesn't respond to 1 kilogram extra, you can always go into the 2 or 3. Nice. So try to make the shoulder go in. Can you stay in front of us on the circle? So don't go around, but go in front. Yeah, shoulder in. Shoulder in. Ah, that was 4 kilograms on the right rein. Nice. So that's already lighter than you did before. Make the circle. That's 8 on the right. As light as possible. So now we see a little bit more pressure diving into the rein on the front, eh? Keep him light. Keep him light. So then we are working on the balance with your leg. Keep the hind leg engaged. Yeah. Nice. Nice. That's it. So can you make the shoulder go in a little bit more? So maybe do a little bit of shoulder in the circle. Yeah. So I don't want him to overbend. Yeah. Nice. So that we are placing him more straight. Yeah. You don't need any more bend in the neck. He is. Yeah, this is enough. Nice. Keep it quick. Yeah, because then he gets a bit slow, and slow that down again. That's interesting. Eh? So I say keep it quick. You give a leg aid, but you have to correct it again and slow him down immediately.
Yeah.
So that leg aid for you to make him quick, he actually gives you a response to the front, eh? To go bigger.
Yeah.
And that makes you have to correct it again. And that is actually conflicting aids. So then we give a leg aid and we have to correct it again on the front. What is the difference between a leg aid for going quicker instead of going bigger? Can you make a different leg aid for that? Because he's confusing the two.
Yeah, it's difficult.
Yeah. So if you do quick, he goes big. Yeah, see, he does it again.
Yeah.
Can we make that different? And then you have to pull it again. Yeah, 10 kilograms. It's okay, but he doesn't understand the quick aid yet. So how can we make a difference? So what you might want to do, yeah, is do a short tapping type of aid for quickness and do a big pushing aid for bigger.
Yeah.
Okay, let's teach him the new difference. Make one for the bigger. You go out of the circle, even if you want to stretch a bit. You do a steady push for bigger, and then he can actually go.
Yeah.
Go, go, go. Good. And now we slow him down again. Nice. Left rein. Yeah. And that was 60 kilograms.
Yeah.
Diving into. That's okay. That's okay. Just to give you a reference. Oh, that's okay. So one more time, we can do a little bit of walk in between, and think about how we make this different.
Yeah.